Hello, I'm Jim Scott, chairman of the Tripp Scott Law Firm. Today we have as our guest Senator Ellen Bogdanoff, whose district is Broward and Palm Beach County, our hometown senator. Welcome, Senator.
Thank you.
So we have quite an interesting scene in Tallahassee with the new governor, new cabinet, and I know there's quite a few issues. What are some of the major issues that you see the legislature facing this year?
Well, I think what we're really trying to focus on is economic development, bringing jobs to Florida, and that's going to encompass a lot of different approaches to how we're going to deal with that issue. And some of it has to do with kind of doing tort reform so that it's a more business-friendly environment, working on things such as tax incentives perhaps, also looking at reducing government regulation. There's a number of reasons that businesses come to Florida. Our tax structure is wonderful. We don't have any personal income tax. There's a good reason for people to come to Florida. The other issues are business, the regulatory environment. That seems to be the number one complaint about most businesses.
So in your capacity as chairman of finance and tax, what do you see as activities for your committee this year?
Well, the good news is there's not going to be a lot of activity because we're not going to be raising taxes. So what we're working on mostly is looking at some property tax reform and, looking at something that could create revenue. Last year, as the finance and tax chair, I ran the jobs bill for Florida and doing some tax credits, creating economic incentives for more businesses to come to Florida. So anything we can do in the arena of building jobs, not raising taxes, and making it a more business-friendly environment so that we can produce jobs for the citizens of the state is what we're going to focus on.
I know one of the major issues is going to be tort reform. It's been stated by business people from other parts of the country that one of the problems they see with locating in Florida is our tort system. Are you going to be involved in working on that?
Well, I'm on the judiciary, and a lot of that stuff comes through judiciary and banking and insurance, so certainly I'll be involved in many of those issues. And there's a myriad of tort reform issues dealing with different aspects of the tort system, so it's a strong balancing act. I'm doing two bills that are in that arena, and one has to do with nursing homes, which is an important part of the district that I represent. There's an awful lot of nursing homes there to kind of create a more balanced approach on that issue. The second one I'm doing is the issue with respect to evidence, the expert evidence, which is Daubert versus the Fry issue. Currently, the federal uses Daubert, Florida uses Fry, and perhaps moving to that system.
How about insurance? Are you going to be working in that area some?
Well, I've got a number of things that we're working on. I think the most important thing that we need to do is to bring back the free market with respect to homeowners insurance. I mean, we spent a number of years because of a direction that we took that was probably not the best direction, which was to kind of expand Citizens Insurance Company. So there's a strong effort to try to reduce the state's exposure in that area, and that'll be good for the citizens of the state, especially if we unfortunately might see a hurricane in the future. I personally am working on trying to try to get rid of the fraud in the personal injury protection area, and that's going to be another bill that we're going to be looking at. I filed that a couple of weeks ago, and hopefully we can help reduce the auto insurance costs by getting rid of the fraud in that system. So there is so much going on. We're doing a lot of reform stuff. That's going to be kind of like the key word. We're doing tax reform, we're doing pension reform, and we're doing tort reform. And the pension reform is going to be a huge issue, not only for the future financial health of the state, but also for the local governments as well that have had a problem in some of the areas in funding their pensions for all of their employees. So that's something that is going to take some time. I mean, the governor certainly came out with his plan. We're also looking at a plan on the Government Operations Committee where it's going through. So hopefully within the first or second week of session, which starts next week, we'll be putting together a bill that we think can pass through both the House and the Senate that's going to engage in some real reform for our pension systems.
I know one of the issues that's been identified by Governor Scott is the area of government reorganization, and particularly in the growth management areas, for example. What do you see happening with that?
I think there's going to be a strong effort. I mean, I don't think everything passes in the first year, but a lot of the members are focusing, because we have over a $4 billion budget deficit and you're not raising taxes, you have to create greater efficiencies in government, reduce government, spend less in government. A lot of that is going to require us to consolidate some of the functions of government, to perhaps get rid of some of the duplication of government. A lot of people believe that some of the agencies are not necessary because we have too many layers in growth management, and that perhaps maybe if we could reduce some of those layers that we would encourage you know, some of that, you know, development that would help bring jobs to Florida. So I think you have a lot of members that you will see in the Senate and in the House working on all kinds of legislation. I mean, I have a particular piece that consolidates the auditing, monitoring, and the inspection functions of all of the, you know, social service agencies. And that should save government several million dollars just on that consolidation alone. So if other members can come up with some creative ideas, those ideas very often come from the public who has to actually, you know, interact with government on a daily basis to get their job done. And if they could just, you know, kind of share with their representatives or their senators, you know, what problems they go through, we can come up with the creative ideas to help consolidate. And that's where this particular idea came from. It came from actually the nonprofit community that has to deal with all of the different agencies when they come in. And, you know, you might have five different agencies come in and do the same report over and over and over again. It just makes sense that you consolidate it. You have one department, and that department shares it with all of the different agencies. And that's, the best ideas come from the people.
I understand that you have worked in the past regarding the pill mill issue and legislation. Is that going to be another issue you're working on this year?
Well, I think we constantly, I think what somebody said to me once is that 80% of what we do in Tallahassee is fix what we did the year before. And we have been attempting to fix the pill mill situation for a long time. We are starting to see additional arrests and sting operations from the law enforcement, which is a good thing, and we need to be their partners in giving them the tools that they need at the state level in order to be more effective at that. And we passed a bill last year that created some problems for legitimate doctors, and we need to fix that as well as figure out where we close the loopholes, because unfortunately in the bill that we did last year there was kind of a loophole that you could probably drive a truck through, and we need to kind of close that so that we don't have problems. But you know, bad actors will always find a way to circumvent the law, and we just need to continue to tweak it so that we can close, you know, those holes that they find.
Right. I know Attorney General Pam Bondi has made this a priority also, so I would expect there would be quite a bit of action in this area.
I think a lot of people are focused on this issue. It has become an epidemic, and I think that there's a huge commitment not only on behalf of the Attorney General, but also on the Governor's Office to try to fix it, and we hope to be good partners in that.
Well, it's obvious from talking to you that you're going to be very active in Tallahassee. I know you work very hard and have worked very hard in the past to represent our area in South Florida and the entire state.
Yeah, I've always enjoyed working with you all. You guys have been a great supporters over the years and a great resource for information, and enjoy having the opportunity to speak with you. But thank you.
Well, thank you very much.